Now that's a proper introduction.
Arrival.
Hi guys, Rocky here. Arrival stars Amy Adams, Jeremy Renner, and Forest Whitaker. Now bear in mind that this review isn't going to have any spoilers because this is definitely a must-see movie. If you get the chance, watch it ASAP. I expected one thing and totally got another, but in one of the best ways possible. Now the movie revolves around Louise Banks, a linguistics professor who leads an elite team into the ship to translate what these aliens are saying, or trying to say anyways. As the United States and the rest of the world teeter on the verge of global war, her crew must race against this time to find a way to communicate with these extraterrestrial visitors, hoping to unravel the mystery. And she takes a chance that could threaten her life and quite possibly all of mankind in the process. Now I gotta say, first and foremost, that this movie was beautifully shot. Everyone in this did a wonderful job. You can tell that not only was it well acted and taken care of, but Denis Villeneuve, the director, actually took his time to make sure that each actor would convey what he was looking for. He had a certain vision, and he really portrayed it in this movie. The story was very well written. The writing credits go to Eric Haysier and Ted Chiang. It's based on a story called Story of Your Life. I've never read it, but I've heard a couple of things about it, and a lot of people actually do like that book. But that being said, this was very well written. I had such an epiphany at the end of the movie that it was shocking and quite striking for me to actually sit there and actually think about what this movie had just done. It's very telling. The movie is very fantastic in that sense. It starts off sci-fi thriller and goes into many different realms. And by the end of the movie, where you end up, you're just shocked, stunned, and it's very well done, beautifully done. Now, Amy Adams, she strikes me as somebody who is very talented, but after watching Batman vs. Superman and Man vs. Steel, I didn't really like her portrayal of Lois Lane, so I wasn't really expecting much out of this. But after watching it, I was very impressed, needless to say. Jeremy Renner always does a good job in whatever he's in. The dude could be halfway drunk and still pull off a really good a good job in whatever he ends up working on. Forest Whitaker, I can take him or leave him. I don't know. Something about him, it's not bad, but it's not great. And I mean, he does good in the position that he's in. He plays Colonel Weber, and it's okay. It's not bad. I have no complaints about Forest Whitaker, but if it was anybody else in that role, it wouldn't have made a difference, really. He gets very little screen time, almost, I would say, a total of maybe 12 to 13 minutes, depending on what's going on. Not all at once, but spread across the movie. All in all, the movie is great, and it is a definite must-see. If you have a chance to watch it in theaters, by all means, do so. I do believe it's coming out on Blu-ray really, really soon, so head on to your local theater, give it a watch, and drop some comments down below on my video and let me know what you guys thought. Did you like it? Do you like the twist? Do you like the story in general? Do you like how it's shot? I'm a big proponent on lighting, directing, and visual style. And each movie is unique. I don't judge them all on the same preface that I expect. Every movie is different. So depending on what genre the movie is, that's what I judge it on and what I'm expecting as far as special effects, lighting, framing of a shot, different things like that, and the lighting in general. But yeah, leave your comments down below. If you like this video, like it. And as always, I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.